Today we'll be discussing frequency domain versus time domain. My name is... What's up everyone? The name is Nick Ben and I'm an engineer here at Keysight. And welcome to this episode of What the RF. In the last episode, we discussed what a spectrum analyzer or signal analyzer is, and the various measurements you can make with it. Today, we'll go into more detail about the difference between the frequency and time domain. All right, so previously we had briefly mentioned the time domain and frequency domain, but what exactly is the difference? And what about the frequency domain tells us more about our signal? Lucky for us, I have this setup here where I'm sending the same signal into the oscilloscope and the signal analyzer. The oscilloscope and signal analyzer are tools to visualize electrical signals in the time and frequency domain, respectively. As you may remember, an oscilloscope displays signals with respect to time versus amplitude, or in the time domain. Here, we're outputting a 10 megahertz signal from the oscilloscope's waveform generator to channel one of the oscilloscope. And visually, this is how it appears on the oscilloscope, as a sinusoidal waveform, with a period of about 100 nanoseconds. Now, if we were to adjust the output from the waveform generator to a 20 megahertz signal, then this is how it would look on the oscilloscope. Once again, as a sinusoidal waveform with a period of about 50 nanoseconds. Basically, the higher the frequency, the more waves we see in the same span on our oscilloscope. Now, in my last video, I got a question from one of you asking what the advantage of a signal analyzer is if you already own an oscilloscope with built-in FFT. Well, I'm glad you asked. Signal analyzers have lower noise floors. This means they are much more sensitive to frequency components and are better at showing you low-level signals. Signal analyzers also have better spurious free dynamic range, or SFDR, than oscilloscopes. All right, so now we have the signal analyzer. And as you may remember, signal analyzers display signals with respect to frequency versus amplitude, or the frequency domain. If we were to output the same 10 megahertz signal from the waveform generator that we had seen earlier on the oscilloscope to the analyzer, this is how it would appear visually, just a single peak at 10 megahertz. And if we were to adjust the output of the waveform generator to be a 20 megahertz signal, then it would be a peak that appears at 20 megahertz. So yeah, in the time domain, signals appear as sinusoidal waves, and in the frequency domain, they appear as distinct impulses. Okay, well, now this begs the question of, why the heck do we care to use a signal analyzer? Is it just to show a wave as a line or something? Well, in a perfect world, we would see the sinusoidal waveform, like the ones we saw on our oscilloscope at frequencies of 10 megahertz and 20 megahertz. Unfortunately, we don't live in a perfect world. When dealing with various devices, it's often you see a not so perfect sine wave with many ripples, like this one that I've now set up by feeding two sine waves from the waveform generator into the oscilloscope. You could say that a real world signal can be represented as a sum of different sinusoidal signals, or rather different frequencies. Now let's say you're designing a product and your product can only operate in a specified bandwidth and it can't be emitting in other bandwidths. Then you must determine at what other frequencies do the other signals exist that are corrupting the signal you want from your device. And that's where our signal analyzers come in. They help separate and display this combination of different sinusoidal signals into their distinct frequency components. So that if you were expecting your device to operate at, let's say, 10 megahertz, you can see all the other frequencies that are messing with your device. For example, this 20 megahertz signal. And once that's figured out, you can use a bandpass filter to tune out those extra annoying signals you weren't expecting. All right, that's it for this episode. Thank you so much.
Grandma?